Hey, what's up guys, it's Ronald here. So this video is going to focus on Brian Molefe returning as the CEO of Eskom. Now, for those of you who live under a rock, Brian Molefe a couple of months ago took an early retirement from Eskom because of the cloud hanging over his head after he was implicated in the former public protector's report on state capture. In it, it showed that he had a very close and uncomfortable relationship with the Gupta family and with Zuma. So much so that he visited the area where the Guptas lived over 40 times. And his excuse was that he never went to their house. He went to a Shebeen in Sachsenwald. Now, to this day, nobody has actually found the Shebeen. So hopefully now that he's returned in his position as the CEO of Eskom, he can possibly point us to the Shebeen, because I'm pretty sure a bunch of people would like to go and drink there. Anyway, I'm getting way ahead of myself. The simple fact of the matter is that Brian Molefe was the CEO of Eskom. Then the state capture report came out, which implicated him in a lot of dodgy deals and also inappropriate relationships with the Gupta family. And he also cost Eskom billions of rands in profits over his term as the CEO. So to get out of this whole funk of things that took place, he sought early retirement from Eskom. What we didn't know at the time was that he was going to get paid 30 million rand for 18 months service as the CEO of Eskom. The good news at least is that the public enterprise minister Lynn Brown rejected this payment from taking place. But as is always the case, we as the public don't really know whether that payment was put through or not. Alright, so back to Brian Molefe. So he decides to take an early retirement from Eskom with a massive cloud hanging over his head of whether or not corruption was involved in all of that. And what do you think the ANC does? That's right. They offer him a position in parliament as a member of parliament. So Brian Molefe becoming a member of parliament had a lot of people scratching their heads at the time, but it soon became pretty clear why he was placed there. The finance minister got axed a couple of months later, and it's clear to see now that Jacob Zuma and the Guptas wanted Brian Molefe to become the new finance minister because it would be a lot easier for them to get access to the treasury. There's a lot of speculation going around as to why Brian Molefe didn't in fact become the finance minister, but it's believed that the top six finally said enough is enough to Jacob Zuma and refused to give in on allowing Brian Molefe to become the new finance minister. So with everything being said and done, here's Brian Molefe. Firstly, he didn't get the 30 million rand payout that was promised to him. And secondly, he didn't become the Minister of Finance as Jacob Zuma probably promised him. So what would be his role in Parliament now? Well, conveniently, the news broke that he's returning as the CEO of Eskom. How convenient, right? It's pretty clear to see for everybody out there that the things didn't play out the way it was supposed to play out, either according to the Guptas or to Jacob Zuma. And there's no need for Brian Molefe being a member of parliament anymore. And that's why he's being pushed back to Eskom, where perhaps he can assist them even more with some dodgy deals in the future. The most shocking statement didn't in fact come from the public. Oh no. The most shocking statement came from the ANC, in which they condemned him for returning as the CEO of Eskom with this massive cloud of doubt hanging over his head. Now please tell me you see the irony in all of this, because that is the same ANC that accepted him with open arms as a member of parliament. So are you honestly telling me that if a cloud of doubt of corruption and all these things hangs over your head, you will be accepted as a member of parliament, but not as a CEO of a big corporation that belongs to the government? Oh my God. So to end off this video, I just want to say that it's absolutely ridiculous what the ANC is getting away with and also what the ANC tolerates. The ANC at one point condemned somebody for returning to a company with a massive cloud hanging over their heads, but at the same time will happily welcome that person with the same cloud over their heads as a member of parliament that is there to serve the people of the country. It's absolutely ridiculous. And that's basically all I've got to say. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a comment below and let me know what you think. Also, be sure to give this video a thumbs up. Let's see if we can reach 1,000 likes with this video. And also, please be sure to subscribe. And if you are subscribed, be sure to hit that bell icon below so that you can be notified of my future uploads. Lastly, please share this video with your friends and family, because that's literally the only way my message gets out there. Till later, cheers and peace out.